It's a typical day at the Highlands County Jail, which means the kitchen is busy. Tasked with feeding the 400-plus inmates in the facility three meals a day, the food services unit enlists inmate workers to prepare and deliver the meals. The meals are all nutritionally balanced, and the menu gets good reviews from many of the inmates.
We do have a nice portion tray because I meet with the dietitian every year and we go over what's the balance and how much they can have. So we do stay within our guidelines, but we give good nutritional food.
While making more than 1,200 meals a day is quite a feat, the most impressive part is that it costs less than $2 to feed an inmate for the day.
Well, you know, we buy in bulk and we do use some of the local farms here, like for the romaine and the cabbage. We have our Maxwell for our oranges and different things like that, watermelons, fresh fruits, fresh vegetables throughout the year, and that really keeps the cost down.
Giving inmates good quality food has added benefits for those tasked with keeping the jail safe.
Jails run on a schedule. Jails run on consistent behavior. Inmates know when to expect a meal and they know what to expect in their meal, and by consistently providing nutritious meals, not leaving the inmates hungry, we avoid other problems. We avoid fights. We avoid security issues. We avoid disturbances and protests. By minimizing those kind of issues, we save money, and food service plays a significant role in that. Ms. Thomas is amazing. She's very budget oriented, but she's also very concerned about the quality of the product she's putting out for that budget. She watches her costs, she shops multiple vendors, but she also tries to source as much of the food served in the jail locally as possible. So she works with local farms to get fresh produce. She buys what's seasonal and that she can get the cheapest, and she'll bring it in by the bushel load to be cooked and served. To bring in $1.80 per day for three filling meals per inmate, it's just astounding.